again to Lindell, and it goes off, shot over.
Puts it up into the area. And a shot. Oh, nice move by Lindell. Lindell puts it up into the area. He's got Parker streaking. Parker shoots and scores.
Continuing in the great tradition of University of Connecticut men's soccer, the 1988 season was one of great accomplishments for head coach Joe Maroney and his Huskies.
What we're looking for in our soccer program is consistency.
Under the direction of 20th-year head coach Maroney, the Huskies qualified for the NCAA Division I National Championship Tournament, marking the 10th time in the last 11 years and the 15th time in the last 17 years that Connecticut has been invited to the National Postseason Classic. With senior Dan Donegan, the Adidas National Player of the Year, leading the offensive charge, Connecticut defied the odds by posting a record of 14 wins, 8 losses, and 1 tie, placing second at the Big East Conference Tournament, and finishing the year ranked number 1 in New England and number 12 nationally. This was the 13th time in the last 15 years that Connecticut concluded the season ranked 16th or better in the nation. All this for the 1988 Huskies, despite losing 7 starters from the 1987 team, and fielding 5 freshmen in the starting lineup this past fall. Consider also that Connecticut's 1988 schedule was once again rated as one of the toughest in the nation. Of Connecticut's regular season opponents, 13 were ranked in the top 20 poll during the year, with 6 teams ranked in the top 10 at some point during the season.
We're clearly a national level team. This has been the era when the, quote, Notre Dames of soccer have been established, and I'd like to feel that we're one of those schools.
Connecticut's great accomplishments did not go unnoticed, as Coach Maroney was voted the 1988 Big East Conference Coach of the Year. Maroney received the Conference Coaching Award for the second time in its 4-year history. For Connecticut's outstanding effort, senior Dan Donegan also received All-America honors for the 3rd consecutive year and was honored as Big East Conference Northern Division Player of the Year for the 2nd season in a row. The Husky team also claimed the 1988 Sampson Trophy as the New England Intercollegiate Soccer League Division I champions. This was the 11th time that Connecticut has been voted the Sampson Trophy winner and the 9th time in Coach Maroney's tenure at the university. Indeed, Coach Maroney's team far exceeded the expectations of many in the soccer world.
Our season was really a successful one. We did an outstanding job. Our players really worked very hard, as I felt that we always do. But all of our games were really exciting in terms of the spectator following. And they were all close. And I felt that we overachieved.
Once again, the Huskies were among the country's leaders in attendance, attracting nearly 46,000 fans to the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. Counting home and away spectators, the Huskies played in front of 52,600 fans in 1988.
The picture tells the story. Connecticut 1, San Francisco nothing.
As in the past, the Connecticut soccer program attracted the largest media following in the nation. Over 50 media members from the newspaper, radio, and television world looked on in November when Connecticut and Boston University met in NCAA National Tournament action at Storrs. Each Husky soccer game, home and away, was carried live throughout Connecticut on WHUS-FM radio in Storrs for the 17th year in a row. Connecticut soccer was the featured team on the New England Sports Network's 1988 college soccer television package. The Huskies appeared on Nesson 13 times in 1988.
So Connecticut have a lot to throw at Eastern Illinois, and it's going to be quite a test for them, I think.
Well, the scene is set. Connecticut against Eastern Illinois live here on ESPN from Palo Alto, California.
Connecticut soccer has been a pioneer in the development of college soccer on television at both the national and regional levels.
Now headed right back to Connecticut. This is DeBrito. He's a dangerous one when he gets it. A bomb, and he's got it! DeBrito didn't waste any time putting Connecticut on the board.
The Huskies have appeared on ESPN over 20 times and have now headlined Nesson's first three seasons of college soccer coverage.
Donegan gets around Fawcett again. Donegan into the area. Donegan pops it out in front. A shot in. Score, Kevin O'Hara.
In its season opener in the Connecticut Soccer Stadium against Philadelphia Textiles, UConn fielded five freshman starters, forwards Rob Lindell and David Hoffman, midfielders Vince Jajuga and Adam Dunn, and back Chris Albrecht.
Chris Albrecht came out and saved what would have been a sure goal.
This was the first time that four or more freshmen had started for Coach Maroney in 11 years.
Young players, freshmen, can come here and start and contribute if they're good enough. At the same time, we're not demanding that they come here and be a star right away. If they can do it, fine. If they don't do it, then there's no problem. We're not going to pressure them.
After starting the year 2-4-1, the young Husky talent fused with the veterans. Connecticut regrouped and became one of the hottest teams in the nation down the stretch of the 88 season, breaking into the national top 20 poll in the process. Connecticut went 11-2 in its last 13 games prior to the Big East tournament. Among the many regular season highlights, Coach Maroney's squad traveled to Las Vegas, Nevada for the Adidas Ethylene Classic in early September for their annual intersectional trip. As testament to their tough schedule, the Huskies met UNLV and UCLA in the tourney, both teams ranked in the top 10.
But it goes across the field.
On September 21st, Connecticut upset then number 4 nationally ranked Harvard 2-1 in Cambridge, Massachusetts in a Nesson televised contest. Brian Parker scored UConn's first goal, and then freshman Adam Dunn added his only goal of the year for the Huskies' game-winning tally. That win turned around the fortunes of the Husky program as it ended Harvard's dominance in New England and established Connecticut as the team to beat in the region.
They have just pulled off an incredible upset, knocking off the number one team in the nation, the Harvard Crimson.
As the defense gelled, Connecticut compiled 7 shutouts in its final 16 games, and yielded just one goal in 12 other games. During this span, junior goalkeeper Tom Foley of Billerica, Massachusetts, set the school record for most consecutive shutout minutes in goal. Foley blanked the opposition for 667 minutes and 24 seconds, not allowing a single goal from September 15th to October 30th, as he started 10 of 14 games during this stretch. Foley posted 6 shutouts on the year. For the 7th year in a row, UConn hosted the Big East tournament at the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. Seeded number 2 in the tournament, Connecticut defeated number 3, Syracuse, 3-1 in the semifinals. Big East Northern Division Player of the Year, Dan Donegan, netted 2 goals and an assist against the Orangemen, while freshman Rob Lindell scored the other Husky goal. In the other semifinal, 2-time defending Big East champion Seton Hall posted a 2-0 victory over Georgetown, setting up a rematch between the Huskies and the Pirates for the Big East Conference title.
As Joe Maroney tries to keep his troops fresh, some say it works, Gary, some say it doesn't, but Joe Maroney has also managed to give a lot of players a lot of experience as you look at him discussing things with Brian Parker.
In the championship game, Seton Hall stopped Connecticut 4-2 in front of 4,409 fans in the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. The only team to qualify for every Big East tourney, the Huskies were making their 5th appearance in the league's title game. Named to the 12-man Big East All-Tournament team were Donegan, who was the tournament's most outstanding performer, senior midfielder Fernando Carlos, senior back Kerry Rudick, and freshman sweeper back Chris Albrecht. Following the Big East tournament, Connecticut was chosen to participate in the 24-team NCAA National Tournament. This was the 17th time Connecticut had appeared in the NCAAs and ranks the Huskies 4th among all Division I teams in most career NCAA tournament appearances. The Huskies drew regional rival Boston University in the first round action. In a torrential downpour at the Connecticut Soccer Stadium, BU took a 2-0 halftime lead. But a goal by Dan Donegan 8 minutes into the final period cut the Terriers' lead to 2-1. The goal in the closing minutes by BU's Jorge Zapata helped the Terriers prevail for a 3-1 final score and end Connecticut's very successful season.
When we recruit, we really look at three things in a prospective student athlete. One, that he be a good person. This is very important to us. Secondly, that he be a very good student. And thirdly, that he be a good soccer player.
Turning to individual performances, once again, senior captain Dan Donegan of Hamilton Square, New Jersey, led the way for the 1988 Huskies. One of the most decorated players in Connecticut soccer history and one of the top collegiate soccer performers over the last 4 years, Donegan added to his already impressive list of accolades in 1988.
And an All-American 3 straight years, that is Dan just stepping forth.
Named All-America for the 3rd successive year, Donegan received the prestigious Adidas Adi Dassler Memorial Award as the nation's top senior player of the year. In addition, the 5'10 forward was runner-up for the Missouri Athletic Club Collegiate Player of the Year Award and was 3rd in balloting for the Robert R. Herman Trophy Award.
He's simply gone out there, played as hard as he could, shown a great amount of durability, and the things that he's done with the ball have been just amazing. I mean, I've just gassed myself sometimes at the things he's done because I say, oh my God, I hadn't seen that before. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it's just so exciting.
For the 3rd consecutive year, Dan led Connecticut in scoring, collecting 11 goals and 11 assists for 33 points as a senior. His importance on the Husky front line was demonstrated by the fact that in games when Donegan scored at least 1 point, the Huskies went 12-3-1 last fall and posted 23 wins, 5 losses, and 3 ties over the last 2 years in games in which Dan scored.
Dan came here, and as a freshman, we had a senior named Matt Addington, who was really one of our All-Americas here, who led the team. But Danny was a winger, and right off the bat, you could see that he had that extra flair and individuality that you don't teach players. It's like a Larry Bird instinct.
The 2nd leading scorer in the Big East, Donegan earned League Male Athlete of the Week honors 3 times in 88, impressively becoming the only athlete in the league to earn the award 6 times in a career. In other honors, Donegan's Big East All-Tournament Award was the 3rd of his career, while he received national recognition on September 11th as Soccer America Magazine's National Player of the Week. He was named the Connecticut Sports Writers Alliance Athlete of the Month for October, becoming the first athlete, male or female, to win that award twice.
And so he's really thrilled the Connecticut fans for the 4 years he's been here.
Donegan ended his career number 5 in all-time Husky scoring with 35 goals and 40 assists for 110 points, becoming only the 5th player in Husky soccer history to surpass the career 100-point milestone.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of room, takes a shot, Foley goes down with the save.
Both Dan Donegan and sophomore goalkeeper Tom Foley were selected to play in the New England All-Star game in November.
Tap left side. Husky's got something going now as Donegan comes in. The goalie coming out. It's chipped out in front. The header. And score by Parker!
Following Donegan in the scoring column were sophomore Brian Parker of Hopewell, New Jersey, who scored 9 goals and 6 assists for 24 points. Parker also added 4 game-winning goals, scoring the winning tallies against Philadelphia Textiles, Boston College, Dartmouth, and Providence.
Donegan up into the area, looking for Lindell with a header. Oh!
Freshman Rob Lindell of Maryland Heights, Missouri, notched 6 goals and 7 assists for 19 points to finish 3rd in Husky scoring. Closing out their Husky soccer careers along with Donegan were seniors Fernando Carlos and Kerry Rudick. Carlos, a 4-year varsity player, appeared in 67 games as a Husky, starting 39 of them. Fernando logged 1 goal and 4 assists for 6 points in 88, ending his career with 4 goals and 8 assists. Kerry Rudick was a 3-year starter at back, playing in 58 games and earning 47 starts. After nursing a preseason knee injury, Rudick started 16 of the final 20 contests in 1988.
In terms of spectator interest, we have yearly since attendance figures have been taken, and even before attendance figures have been taken, have drawn more fans at our game than any other college soccer program in the country.
As a national leader in attendance, Connecticut soccer attracted 46,000 fans to its 15 home contests at the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. The home crowds again watched the Huskies enjoy great success as Connecticut was 10-4-1 at Storrs in 1988. Over the past 4 years, during the careers of seniors Donegan, Carlos, and Rudick, Connecticut registered an impressive mark of 42 wins, 12 losses, and 5 ties at home, winning 75.4% of its games in front of its loyal following of fans.
Slides it sideways, nifty move by DeBrito. He maintains possession. He'll shoot it from there. You got to watch him. Chipped upfield by Lyman for Dorsani. This game is over!
The great tradition of Connecticut soccer continued strong in 1988 with another winning season, another top 20 national ranking, and another NCAA national tournament berth for the Huskies.
Soccer is my life here. And as a result, you treat it with a little more seriousness than just simply another day at work.
Connecticut soccer, Coach Maroney guiding his youngest team in recent memory to the championship game of the Big East tournament and to the number one ranking in New England. Connecticut soccer, one of the nation's top soccer programs and one of the nation's attendance leaders in soccer year in and year out, featuring the outstanding play of All-America forward Dan Donegan, a Friends of Connecticut soccer support group of 600 members strong.
The indoor program, the spring program, this have all been very important, and this has all coincided now with our formation of our Friends Club, which is, again, a very viable organization, a supporting group here. We have a hospitality area before each game. We have post-game joint team meals with our visiting team. No other school in the country does that. And this is an educational experience to be able to play hard against the team and then go have dinner with them.
Nice defensive play by Robbins. But Jujuga gets it in front. Carlos, Parker with a nice lead for Jujuga, score!
Connecticut soccer, receiving tremendous television exposure on the New England Sports Network for a third consecutive year.
Donegan into the area. Donegan pops it out in front. A shot in. Score, Kevin O'Hara. Here's Hoffman. Hoffman was onside. Hoffman shoots and scores.
Oh, that was Lindell. Now again to Lindell. And a good shot over.
Christopher Hagan and a nice save by Foley in front.
Connecticut soccer. A stadium filled to capacity to witness the Huskies taking on top regional and national opponents. NCAA National Tournament participants, bringing plenty of excitement to the UConn campus and to the state of Connecticut. All this is soccer at the University of Connecticut.
You get nothing for nothing. You have to work hard. Life is not always fair. And when these young people get out into the world after they graduate, they're going to find out that it's a very competitive situation out there. And they need to be prepared properly, and they need to know that what they have to do to be successful. That's my job. And I feel that our program helps them in this regard. And so, you know, the competition they face, the ups and downs that they go through while they're here and as a player of the team, maybe they're starting, you know, the beginning of the season, but play poorly and lose their position. They have to work to get it back. That's all the kind of thing that's going to happen when they leave here. So it's a good real life situation with not the same kind of pressures attached.
Autumn in New England. Peaceful, warm, colorful, picturesque.
Puts it in front for O'Hara. Score!
An action-packed excitement in the University of Connecticut Soccer Stadium. Produced by Coach Joe Maroney's Huskies, the 1989 Big East Conference champions. consistency and a tradition of success. That is the history of the University of Connecticut men's soccer program, and the 1989 season was no exception. Making its 18th NCAA national tournament appearance, Connecticut again finished the year as one of the nation's top soccer teams.
Clearly, we were able to be successful in that we achieved all of our objectives for the year, which was a winning season. We ended up being in the finals of the Big East Conference, and we did win the Big East Conference championship, and that enabled us to get into the NCAA tournament for the 16th time in the last 18 years. So I felt really very comfortable with the way the season went.
Under the direction of 21-year head coach Joe Maroney, the Huskies finished with 12 wins, 5 losses, and 5 ties, won the 1989 Big East Conference championship, and gained their 16th NCAA national tournament berth in the last 18 years. In addition, Coach Maroney collected his 350th collegiate victory with a 2-0 win over Boston College in the Big East Tournament semifinals on November 3rd. Maroney is one of only 4 active collegiate soccer coaches to reach 300 career victories. Although the team was racked by injuries throughout the season, the Huskies relied on balanced scoring and a solid defense to again post impressive numbers and achievements during the 1989 season.
The UConn Huskies, the 1989 Big East champions.
The crowning moment of the 1989 season occurred on Sunday, November 5th in the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. A crowd of 4,638 watched the Huskies defeat Seton Hall 3-1 for the Big East Conference title and the league's automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. The Pirates, defending Big East champions, were stymied by a tough Connecticut defense led by junior goalkeeper Tom Foley from Billerica, Massachusetts. Foley was voted the most outstanding performer at the Big East tournament. Joining Tom Foley on the Big East all-tournament team were Husky senior co-captain and back Bill Lawrence of Columbia, Connecticut. Senior co-captain midfielder Kevin O'Hara of Flushing, New York. And sophomore sweeper back Vince Jajuga of Glencoe, Illinois. Connecticut advanced to the 28-team NCAA National Tournament for the 11th time in the past 12 years before being handed a 2-0 setback by Vermont in the first round action in Burlington, Vermont on November 11th. The Huskies standing among the nation's elite is shown by the program's 18 NCAA tournament berths. Only 3 schools have made more NCAA soccer tournament appearances than Connecticut. The man responsible for Connecticut's tremendous success is head coach Joe Maroney. Entering his 22nd year as head coach, the Huskies have had 12 winning seasons in a row, have won 9 New England titles, and rank among the top 10 Division I teams in the nation in winning percentage.
Parker gets the ball through, shot by Hoffman off the crossbar.
I want us to be a Notre Dame of soccer, if you will, in terms of getting a national reputation and being able to maintain it.
The nation's number one innovator in the sport of soccer, Coach Maroney has increased the visibility of soccer to levels not previously known. Each year, the country's top-ranked teams come to the Connecticut Soccer Stadium. Howard, North Carolina, and Seton Hall were among the ranked teams to play at stores this fall.
More important to me, however, has been the fact that we've been able to recruit good people, which is our first criteria when we recruit. Secondly is to recruit good students, and our players have graduated. And thirdly, of course, good soccer players. So think of them as a student first and an athlete second, and we indicate to them that we're not interested in redshirting them for improvement on the field. We're interested in having them come here and graduate in 4 years.
Recognizing the need for a strong support group for the sport, Coach Maroney began the very popular Friends of Soccer group years ago. The club publishes the game programs, co-sponsors and operates the UConn Metropolitan Life Indoor Soccer Classic, holds post-game banquets for visiting teams, holds the annual team awards banquet, provides awards for players, sponsors a hospitality tent at home and selected away games, and on top of all that, raises funds for scholarships. Membership in this group now tops 600 loyal followers.
An effort in making this game a success.
Through the efforts of Coach Maroney and the Friends Club, the Huskies made collegiate soccer history in August when they played host to the Soviet National Cup champion Dnepr on August 20th. Connecticut became the first United States college soccer team to face a major European soccer club and was the first to meet an opponent from the Soviet Union.
exhibition match against Dnepr from the Ukraine gave Connecticut the chance to face one of the world's premier professional soccer clubs in the spirit of international goodwill. The day-long event featured a motorcade through campus, a match in front of 4,000 spectators, and a post-game dinner where gifts were exchanged with the visitors from the Ukraine. Highlighting the play of the 1989 Huskies with a quartet of junior goalkeeper Tom Foley, sophomore back Vince Jajuga, and junior forwards Brian Parker and Danny Sanchez. In goal, Tom Foley turned in his best season to date. Named to the New England All-Star team, Tom had 9 shutouts and was third among all goalkeepers in the region with his 0.84 goals against average. Foley turned in a brilliant performance at the Big East tournament, shutting out Boston College 2-0 in the semifinals. Foley returned to the nets against Seton Hall and had 11 saves in Connecticut's 3-1 championship game victory. Twice voted the Big East Male Athlete of the Week during the season, Foley's superb performance in the Big East tournament won him the tournament's most outstanding performer award.
It's an unbelievable feeling. I have to thank all the guys on my team. Brian Anderson did a great job on Ian Hennessy. Chris Albrecht did a great job on Pat O'Kelly. The whole team did a wonderful job today.
And what's it like playing in front of a crowd like this in a frenzy from the get-go?
Well, I tell you, the fans are like a 12th man on the field. They do a great job for us. They come out and they support us. And even when we were struggling in the beginning of the year, they were there for us. And you also have to thank them because they helped out today.
The junior duo of Brian Parker and Danny Sanchez provided the offensive punch all year long. Parker of Hopewell, New Jersey, led UConn in scoring with 7 goals and 9 assists. Sanchez, a Scottsdale, Arizona native, was playing in his first season at Connecticut and scored 6 goals and 7 assists. Of his 7 goals, 3 were game winners. Parker finished the year 7th in New England scoring, while Sanchez was 10th. Vince Jajuga earned Big East Tournament and All-New England honors at the end of the season with his outstanding play in the Husky backfield. Jajuga also contributed 4 goals and 2 assists. Senior co-captains Kevin O'Hara and Bill Lawrence provided staunch leadership in the midfield and backfield. Both were named the Big East All-Tournament team for the champion Huskies. O'Hara also punched in 4 goals and 4 assists. Another top Husky player was sophomore forward Rob Lindell. Lindell collected 25% of the Husky assists, finishing the season with 10 assists plus 1 goal. Lindell also made Connecticut soccer history by assisting on 5 consecutive goals against Dartmouth, Harvard, Fairleigh Dickinson, and Providence.
New England College Soccer 89 has been an exclusive presentation of NESN, your New England sports network.
Connecticut soccer is second to none in television, radio, and print media coverage. Husky soccer is a pioneer in both extensive radio and television coverage.
So Connecticut have a lot to throw at Eastern Illinois, and it's going to be quite a test for them, I think.
Well, the scene is set. Connecticut against Eastern Illinois live here on ESPN.
The Huskies have appeared on ESPN over 20 times.
This is DeBrito. He's a dangerous one when he gets it. A bomb, and he's got it! DeBrito didn't waste any time putting Connecticut on him.
And are now headlining the New England Sports Network's first 4 seasons of college soccer coverage. This fall, Connecticut soccer was the featured team on the New England Sports Network for the 4th year in a row. Huskies appeared on NESN's college soccer television package 11 times. NESN reaches nearly 400,000 homes in the New England region.
Chip Storr, the middle.
That's going to score!
Each Husky soccer game, home and away, is carried live throughout Connecticut on WHUS-FM radio. WHUS Radio has provided Husky soccer coverage for the last 18 years, giving the Connecticut program the most extensive radio coverage of any NCAA soccer team in the country. As in the past, the Connecticut soccer program attracts the largest media following in the nation and is featured on regional TV week in and week out. Each Husky soccer game, home and away, is covered by numerous newspaper, radio, and television outlets from the state of Connecticut. 40 media members were on hand to cover the Huskies' march to the 1989 Big East Conference title. University of Connecticut Soccer, one of the nation's top soccer programs, featuring a stadium filled to capacity, the nation's finest television, radio, and newspaper coverage, and a Friends of Soccer support group over 600 enthusiastic members strong.
The University of Connecticut.
Connecticut Soccer, the 1989 Big East champions, an NCAA national tournament team going to the elite postseason tournament for the 14th time in the last 16 years. Connecticut Soccer, bringing plenty of excitement year in and year out to the UConn campus and to the state of Connecticut.
Foley with a save.
The 1989 Big East Conference men's soccer champions, the University of Connecticut.
These are the words me hear from my granddaddy. Come, these are the words me hear from my granddaddy. If there's nothing in this world like when a man know him free. Free from the lock of Mr. Free from the key. Free like a butterfly, free like a bee. These are the words me hear from my granddaddy. Said it's nice to be free, nice to be free. Free from the lock of Mr. Free from the key. Don't be afraid of your freedom.
Cause I'm free to do what I want.
Yeah. Let me take you to a place I know you wanna go. It's a good life.
Yeah, she's a promise in the year of election.